When I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, we gather today. We gather today as a family over social media to give thanks to God and to express in our very isolated way our love and affection for Helen Hunter Anderson, whose funeral rites take place today. You might be gathered as a family in various houses, in various degrees of isolation, but we gather in the presence of God, the presence of the saints, to pray for, to give thanks to God for our sister Helen, to pray that she is at peace, to give thanks for her life, to celebrate these sacred mysteries worthily. Let us acknowledge our own faults and failings.
You raise the dead to a life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. You give pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. You give light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. O God, who are the mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Helen, for whom today we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, she may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We now listen to the scripture readings which are now offered by Helen's family.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We shall stay with the Lord forever. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of the Lord, the voice of the archangel will call out to the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. This is the word of the Lord.
Oh, The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, I tell you most solemnly, whoever keeps my word will never see death. The Jews said, Now we know for certain you are possessed. Abraham is dead, and the prophets are dead, and yet you say, Whoever keeps my word will never know the taste of death. Are you greater than our father Abraham, who is dead? The prophets are dead too. Who are you claiming to be? Jesus answered, If I were to seek my own glory, that would be no glory at all. My glory is conferred by the Father, by the one of whom you say, He is our God, although you do not know him. But I know him, and if I were to say, I do not know him, I should be a liar, as you are liars yourselves. But I do know him, and I faithfully keep his word. Your father Abraham rejoiced to think that he would see my day. He saw it and was glad. And the Jews said, You are not 50, yet how can you have seen Abraham? Jesus replied, I tell you most solemnly, before Abraham was ever, I am. At this they picked up stones to throw at him, but Jesus hid himself and left the temple. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. It was on the 17th of July, 1944, that Margaret and Alfie, or Alphonsus Anderson, welcomed into the world their daughter, Helen. Helen's mother had been previously married to two others, therefore she was numbered amongst a group of siblings which involved five stepbrothers and stepsisters. But such was the gap, Helen really considered herself an only child. She was born and brought up in the Garngad, Royston Hill, or Royston as it's known now, but it's the Garngad, although you will never find a sign in Glasgow which says the Garngad. But to Glaswegians of a generation, when you mention the Garngad, we know exactly where you are. And indeed, like Catholics who were born and brought up in the Garngad, Helen went to St. Rocks. The Wee Rock and the Big Rock, as the schools are affectionately known. And it was at St. Rocks that she met her future husband, her best pal, and married David Anderson. And their first home together was down here in the Calton, just not far from here. It was a single end, and it was in Wells Street. Later on, the family home being in Green Street. They had three children, to Margaret, Janie and David, to whom today I personally, along with the whole parish, offer our sincerest and deepest condolences to Margaret and Andrew, to Janie and George, and to David and Anne-Marie. It goes without saying that a significant part of Helen's character, and I suppose her gifts and qualities, was the ability to make a happy, joyful household, a good mother. And she not only brought up her family, but she found a great blessing in them. And she extended that gift of her family, the gift of her married love to David, to welcoming in foster children. Scores, literally scores, if not hundreds of children have found love from Helen. They found tremendous love that she offered. And indeed, even after David died in 1997, which is something that
terribly struck Helen. She continued to foster because that got her through. In fact, being her, being a homemaker and loving and caring was really her gift. She didn't have many pals that she ran about with as so because her family was her life. And she had no greater pride than in her grandchildren of Jennifer, David, Ashley, Drew, Gemma and Abby. And here in this place on this day, I offer my sincere condolences to them too as they try to say goodbye to their gran. But the Christian funeral is never a forever goodbye, because we believe that in death, life is only changed, it's not ended. By the grace of God, one day we will see Helen again. We'll see her smile, we'll experience her love. And that is made possible by one thing, and that's the love of God. We listen to our scripture readings, which give us comfort. But we listen to the gospel where Jesus reveals who he is. He's the Son of God, and those who keep his word will never die. We ask that God sees the goodness that Helen lived in her life and rewards her for that. In these difficult days, when every one of us is faced with our mortality, the possibility of dying, of having to meet God and be accountable for our lives, perhaps we give sharp focus that what we're doing here and now in this sacred and holy place is doing what Jesus asked us to do. Asked us to do in memory of him, to offer his bread and blood, his bread and wine to become his body and blood at Holy Mass. All of us being separated as families at this time, maybe it offers us an opportunity to, when these times pass, to treasure and value the more important things in life. I think Helen gave an example of that by how she was able to mother, nurture and care for so many. She who mothered and nurtured and cared, we pray, has been mothered, nurtured and cared by our Blessed Mother. You can see here in St. Mary's just over my shoulder, the image of Our Lady of the Assumption, Mary being welcomed into heaven to be crowned as Queen. To that Queen of Heaven we pray that she welcomes Helen home, that she's at rest, at peace, that she's with her husband David and resting in the hope and sleep of the just. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Let's now listen to the intercessions and the prayers of the faithful praying for our sister Helen.
For Helen, who as a Baptist was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may not be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us. For Helen, that may find eternal rest in the presence of Christ. Lord, hear us. For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all those who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, and they may see God face to face, Lord, hear us. For the family and friends of Helen, and they may have been consoled in the grief by the Lord, Lord, hear us. For all us that gathered here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become for us our spiritual drink. May the Lord receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice that we offer him with humbled and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquities, cleanse me from my sins. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice to your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Helen, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Pleni sunt caeli et terra, Gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Philip our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, at this point in Holy Mass, we pray together in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, my peace I give you, my peace I leave you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. This point in Mass we normally exchange to those round about as the sign of peace. So if you're at home with someone, why don't you offer them a hug of peace, a kiss of peace. If you're isolated and on your own, know that walls don't confine that love and peace of Christ, that you're never alone. None of us are ever alone. Nothing comes between us and the love of Christ.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Helen, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, we now join Helen's immediate family at St. Peter's Cemetery in Dobeth, where we will place her sister to rest in the hope of rising again. In peace, let us take Helen to her place of rest. Amen.
Says, blessed is the Lord our God. Blessed is the Lord our God. And praise to you, Lord of all creation. Praise to you, holy and living God. We praise you and we bless you forever. We bless you and we thank you and we praise you for your kindness. Respond. Blessed is the Lord our God. You sanctify the homes of the living. You make holy the places of the dead. For you alone open the gates of righteousness and lead us to the dwellings of the saints. Blessed is the Lord our God. We praise you, our refuge and strength. We bless you, our God and Redeemer. Your praise is always in the hearts and on our lips, and we remember the mighty deeds of the covenant. Blessed is the Lord our God, almighty and ever-living God. Remember the mercy with which you graced your servant Helen in life. Receive her, we pray, into the mansions of the saints, as we make ready our sister's resting place. Look also with favour on those who mourn, and comfort them in their loss. Lord Jesus Christ, almighty God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it, as we bury here the body of our sister. Deliver her soul from every bond of sin, that she may rejoice in you with the saints forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister, and may our farewell express our affection for her, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we'll joyfully meet her again. The love of Christ will conquer all things, destroy even death commend the soul of Helen. Thank you.